This month, dedicated to all souls, is a reminder of the great privilege that is ours, the duty that is ours, to pray for all the faithful departed. As we do at this Mass, and as we will do so as we bless the graves following this liturgy, with love and affection, we pray for Bishop Gosman and Bishop Waters, who are buried in this cemetery, and for all the deceased, bishops and priests and deacons and religious and lay faithful, who have served so well in this diocese throughout the years. No doubt all of us who gather today are also praying for our own deceased parents and grandparents, and family members and friends who have died, asking God to grant them eternal peace. And on a solemn day like today, there are many emotions. There's sadness and longing. There's thanks and gratitude. There's a renewed understanding of the challenge we all embrace as we continue this journey on earth. It's understandable why there's sometimes sadness and longing in our hearts when we pray for the faithful departed, because we miss them. We miss their physical presence and their conversations and their company. And it's only because of that love that we are able to entrust them to God and to the blessings that await them. I'll never forget my mother's words at the time of her death, when she said to us, "Let me go to God." And it's only love and it's only faith that allows you to say yes at such a solemn moment. Their spirit of gratitude and thanks in our hearts today because of God's promises. The Book of Wisdom: the souls of the just are in the hands of God, and grace and mercy are with them. Jesus' own words: "I have prepared a place for you, that where I am, you also may be." Thanks and gratitude for God's promises, the God who is always faithful. But we continue this journey here on earth, and so we embrace a challenge today. For it's not enough for us to only have heartfelt sentiments and memories of those who have died. We must be willing to allow the example of their lives to live on in us. As we strive daily on this journey to imitate their faith, their goodness, sacrifices, courage, so that in and through our lives, we may proclaim Christ as the way who shows us the right path on this journey here on earth, as the truth who is always there to enlighten and guide us, and as the life who sustains us, most especially as we eat his body and drink his blood. What a great privilege it is to be together this day, to know the love and support of our church, when together at this Mass and at every Mass, we proclaim the great truth that by his own cross and resurrection, Jesus has transformed suffering to glory and death to life. It's that truth that allows us with renewed faith and in joyful hope to entrust our faithful departed to God as we ask the Lord to grant them eternal peace and fullness of life forever and ever. Amen.